Okay, assalamualaikum. So today we are going to look into our last subtopic in topic 2, that is the pipe networks. So as we can see here, there is the interconnecting pipe of this pipe networks. So here we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 loops. So this pipe network receive flow inflow from Q1 that flowing to point C, and also flow Q inflow from Q2 that flow into point I. So this flow rate also had discharge to point 3 Q3 and discharge at point A, that is Q4. So as we can see here, there are different direction of each pipe. Okay, so definitely it will bring the different flow rate. So here, how we can identify the flow rate for each pipe? So we use Hardy cross analysis. Okay, so also we will use the method of iteration. Okay, we make some assumption and then we will do some correction, and then we will get until we get the final answer. So here we also use equation for head loss when the Q is known, and also head loss if the K coefficient resistance. So now look at this example. So here we have two loops, so with a few pipe inlet and outlet. So how we can identify the flow rate in each pipe? So first, we will assume the at point A, 500 liter per second flowing into point A, and then we'll be separate by pipe A to F and A to B. So 500 will be divide into 300 liter per second and 200 liter per second. So at point F, it will receive 700 inflow. So when it receive 300 from A, so 7 plus 300 will get 1000. So the flow flowing from F to E is 1000. So how about point B? So at point B, had received 200, so it will divide this flow into two direction, that is B to E 100 and B to C 100. So kita dah solve for loop 1. Okay, so bila kita tengok dekat point E, we have this charge of 400. So we know that point E receive 1000 plus 100, so 1100 at point E, but had been discharged 400, so the remaining 700 will flow to point D. But again, at point D had been discharged 500, so at point D it will remain 200 to point C. So point B had been divided into 100 to BC, so 200 plus 100, so we'll get 300 discharge to point at point C. So how you know that your first assumption is correct is when you got the balance Q in must equal to Q out. So kita dah solvekan dua-dua loop ni. Bila each of this pipe dah ada flow rate, so kita transfer to the table. Okay, so kita buat untuk satu per satu loop. Okay, so loop 1 and loop 2 in a separate table. So here we have column for pipe and diameter for the pipe, the length, and then the K, resistance coefficient, and then the assumed Q yang tadi 500 kita divide in, dekat point A tadi. Okay, and then the formula. Okay, so now kita letak pipe tu one by one. Okay, first F to A. Why F to A? Because kita assume loop ni will face will have ada satu direction saja, that is clockwise direction. Okay, idea kita assume mengalir in a the same direction, that is clockwise. Okay, so kita ambil lah dia from point F to A. Okay, so from F to A, okay, and then A to B, B to E, and E to F. Okay, sebab clockwise kan, F to A, A to B, B to E, E to F. Kita buat untuk loop 1 sahaja, jangan usik loop 2 dulu ya, untuk kolom yang ni, untuk table yang ni. So untuk kolom diameter, kita masukkan lah masing-masing punya floor diameter, and then also the length. So next kita ada kolom K. How you get K? It is from the H Darcy yang ada Q equation tu. Okay, 3.03 D power of 5 ni, so equal to H equal to K Q square, kan? Okay, so bila kita matikan the Q, so yang tinggal range, so yang dapat K FL over 3.03 D power of 4, ya, power of apa ya ni, power of 5. Okay, sorry. Okay, so kita dah dapat F, kita given F 0.01, so masukkan F, masukkan L yang untuk each pipe lah kan. Okay, and then masukkan juga diameter untuk each pipe, so dapat K for each pipe. Next kita calculate assume Q. So assume Q means direction Q yang mengalir dekat pipe FA. So meaning that U ada direction dari A ke F, kalau dari figure ni. But when U nak transfer to the table, kita write dia punya pipe is from F to A. So meaning kita punya direction will be opposite. So that's why kita ada negative 300 di sini. Negative, kita letak negative sebab dia F to A, yang direction daripada figure is A to F, 300 positif. Tapi bila kita letak dalam table is F to A, so kita letak negatif, simbol negatif, jangan lupa. And then A to B, again A to B kita positif lah sebab ikut direction dia sendiri kan, dalam figure A to B, and dalam table pun A to B, so kita remain positif. B to E pun sama, remain positif. Tapi again E to F kita ada negative 1000. Sebab apa? Sebab kita tulis dia dalam table E to F, but the direction is from F to E, so kita letak negative dekat 1000. Okay, now we can calculate the H equal to K times Q square. So K dah kita dapat, and then Q square kita gunalah assume Q. So masukkan dalam formula, and then kita calculate juga H over Q, so dapatkan. And then you total up this H and totalkan H over Q. Untuk apa? Untuk kita dividekan dia dalam equation, the correction of Q. So we will have negative over here, so letak juga negative, jangan tinggalkan. Okay, but bila negatif, kita jumpa negatif dalam formula, so it will become positive for the answer. So for positive 0.09 meter per second, since kita punya L, kita punya Q tadi in liter per second, so kita akan kita is in meter cube per second, right? Okay, so kita liter per second. Okay, so kita akan tolakkan untuk dapatkan flow rate, the new flow rate negative 300 plus 90, so you will get negative 210. Okay, negative 210. So goes with A to B. Okay, 200 plus 90, so you get 290. Then this one 100 plus 90, you get 190. And then negative 1000 plus 90, you get negative 910. So that is your the new Q, okay, daripada yang kita assume masa mula-mula tadi. So kita solve untuk loop tu sama juga macam mana you nak transferkan pipe tu, ikut dia punya, ikutlah dia punya clockwise direction. Okay, so kalau E to B, so dia punya value is positive 100. Okay, B to E is positive 100, but you letak dalam table is E to B, so negative 100. So you letak sini negative 100. Okay, B to C 100. Okay, so you ingat macam mana you nak transfer from the figure into this table. Okay, dalam table mesti ikut clockwise satu arah saja. Tak nak ada yang clockwise and then ada yang pipe yang anti clockwise. Nanti you punya new ni akan salah. Okay, so sama you kira lah untuk setiap table or column, so you will get the different correction of Q. Okay, so again you ambil yang assume Q negative 100 plus 68. Okay, you will have negative 100 plus 68. Betul, you kira balik yang ni. Okay, sebab 100 plus 68, you will get 168. Kan, so negative 200 plus 68, you will get negative. Okay, so yang untuk yang ni you kira balik. Okay, the miscalculation is tu. Okay, so again once you settle for your first correction, so kita tak boleh stop kat situ sebab kita tak tahu lagi dia punya flow rate tu dah betul-betul yang accurate ke belum. Okay, so kita kena buat untuk second correction. Again, masukkan ikut saja untuk first correction tadi ya. Dia punya pipeline ni, and then dia punya diameter pun samalah, tak ada perubahan. And then K sama, boleh kira ke? Tak perlu, sebab F sama, L sama. Okay, so yang lain adalah dekat assume Q. So kita ambil yang mana dekat assume Q ni? Kita ambil daripada first correction. Okay, first correction negative 210, so masukkan dekat second correction. Okay, negative 210. Lepas tu masukkanlah masing-masing punya pipe, and then you dapat dah. Okay, and then you kira H, you kira H over Q, then you dapat dividekan dia soal equation, then you dapat 30.5. and then from the assumed Q negative 210 plus 30.5, you get negative 179.5. Okay, so I think yang lain betul. Okay, and then again dah settle loop 1, kita buat untuk loop satu persatu ya. Loop 1, and then you settlekan loop 2, and then you dapat correction dia. You compare kan, okay, correction, okay, between first correction and second correction, the value makin kecil. Betul tak? Tadi ni 9.